Everybody, Dark Prince Plays here, and welcome to Let's Play number 13. So, yeah, those of you, well, I kind of went over this in the announcement video, so I'm not going to do it again. But, yeah, welcome to Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle. Probably one of the most bizarre crossovers in video game history. I mean, I grew up playing both Mario and Rabbids games, specifically like Rabbids Go Home. There was also Raving Rabbids TV Party that I played. And I was pretty intrigued by this when it was first announced. And even though I have not finished the game, yeah, I've played most of it, but this is another game that I've not finished, so I'll know what I'm doing up to a point, and then just kind of going blind from there. But I am kind of familiar with this game, and I remember, like, about a year ago, half a year ago, I was, like, really into this game, and, like, I knew, like, a lot of stuff about it. So hopefully, like, once I actually get back to playing, I'll, like, remember a bunch of things, like, the different characters and how they work. Okay, he totally disappeared before the frame shifted, but, or the scene changed. But yeah. So yeah, and also I should probably point this out. I'm not gonna be getting 100%. Like, I won't be getting like all the treasure chests and stuff, because if I try, I'll get as many as I can, but I'm not gonna like stress out about not getting any, or like I'm not gonna stress about missing any, because if I do that, we will be here forever. Here's my personal file, and here's the TRI file that we need to get back to eventually. And I saved this one specially for my LP. So, without further ado, let us begin.
That ought to fix the overheating problem. Can you believe it's been 3 months since Tech Magazine put me... Okay, us, on the cover?
The Super Merge takes item A and item B and combines them to create item C!
Ugh, if only it were that easy. The article says nothing about dark matter, space-time manipulation, practical applications, nothing! I mean... The Super Merge could solve the energy crisis, Beepo. Watch! Huh?
Oh, not again.
Oh, I'm sorry, Beepo. Let's take a break and come back at this overheating thing fresh, okay?
For anyone who hasn't put two and two together, the Rabbids are most certainly the minions before the minions. And yes, they are always like this.
Thank you.
and the girl was never seen of again. And also, yes, this is a cutscene that's been used in so many fake Mario movie trailers.
No! I just got done saving you from the mansion! Or the hotel, I mean.
Looks like someone got a game over in Mario Galaxy. Okay. Yeah, let's just assume that Luigi's Mansion 3 just happened, like, about a month ago. Even though Luigi's Mansion 3 came out after Kingdom Battle, but... I don't think Kingdom Battle's canon, is it? I doubt it. Well, Mario RPGs are spinoffs. Why do I have ears? So why do they have headphones? Why does the thing have headphones?
Well, I hope you're happy.
I really need to find footing for Beepo's voice, because Jack was the one who voiced him in TRI. That Rabbid Mario. Now for another few months after this released. Okay. Welcome to Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle. Yeah, you got him. How'd that not get all over them? And just the Goombas. And this thing. Aww. And right off the bat, we get our first enemy type. Ziggy, dashing ne'er-do-wells. Near.
Those rabbits, they seem to be driven to cause chaos and mayhem. More so than usual, even.
See, no pots and pans in the background to crash the background audio now.
Unlike our two friends here, they seem to have been corrupted by the rabbit wearing the Super Merge headset.
The Super Merge!
Could it be the Super Merge headset? Could it be the Super Merge headset was corrupted on its way to this world? If so, we're all in terrible danger. Mario, we must find that poor rabbit fused to the headset. He's the key. Save him. We might just save this world.
And already, World 1-1, unlikely heroes. So, yeah, basically how this works, we move around, we cannot jump. All we can do is move. And pause. Yeah, that's pretty much all we can do right now. And interact.
A shocking, though admittedly hilarious, example of the chaos wrought by the intrusion of our world into this one.
I think he says the same thing as the other ones. Yeah, I'm not going to interact with absolutely everything, but again, I'm going to be trying to do as much as I can. Aw, look at the little bees. So yeah, funny how I'm playing this like a little bit after Sparks of Hope comes out. I want to say like about a month. And Mario's dead. Again. Rabbid Peach in the back just... Ugh. Her face.
Help me! I can't get clear! Thank you so much!
Why does it sound like a little bit higher pitched voice or version of King Boo? Also, hold on. Why? Why did I have to get somewhat sick this morning? Why? The day I was, like, I finally get a chance to record, and of course I don't feel well for it.
Oh, what is it now? I just received a message.
Dearest Beepo, whose bravery, intelligence, and compassion stands as a beacon of hope for us all. If my timing is correct, you are in dire need of help. There's a reason I'm doing this voice. Please open the attachments to this message. Their receipt is most auspicious, I assure you. Signed, your biggest fan. Ooh, explodes.
Huzzah.
Wow, when the email said attachments, I thought it was talking about cat videos or something. So, are you guys ready to fight back?
What is it with them despawning, like, how they keep despawning? But yeah, Sparks of Hope came out, like, a little bit ago, but it was always my plan to play King to battle first. So,
careful now, my sensors detect two enemies on the battlefield. One is hiding behind partial cover, so you'll have to hit... So your chance to hit it is 50%. The other is out in the open, giving you a 100% chance to hit it. You can cycle through targets with the left stick. Press A to shoot the selected target.
And yeah, you can also change your hero with L and R. We can really only shoot. We can't move yet. So I'll just shoot him with Mario. 26 damage. So as we're just kind of testing the waters, let me explain a couple things. So yeah, Ziggies are the most basic enemy type, and they do change their designs for each world. So yeah, there are other worlds. Thought I'd point that out. And they, even though they are the same enemy type, they do change their designs. And I also believe they act more aggressive as you go on, I think, but I could be wrong. Oh yeah, and they also get like different stats and stuff.
Cowards! Now they're all behind full cover. We have 0% chance of hitting them from here. We'll only hit their cover. We need to flank them. Move around with your left stick to position yourself for a shot with 100% chance of hitting.
Also, I should mention this: brick covers can be broken if shot or if you deal enough damage to them. But like metal-like covers like this are unbreakable. And yeah, and I didn't think you could do this already, but there's no reason to do it. You can also bounce off of your allies. Yeah. I should also... maybe not. I'll kind of go more in depth to what each hero does as we go along. Yeah, now he'll get a chance to attack, so yeah. And he does have more HP than the other ones, because that was just, like, the very first thing. Oh yeah, and not only can you possibly hit them for 50%, but they can also hit you for 50%, depending on where you are. Can I hit you? Yes. You are dead.
No big surprise.
Fairly simple so far, but don't worry, it gets pretty complicated later, and I should probably turn on the lights, so enjoy this! Just, like, curb stomping him into the trophy.
Like, just eat it. Consume trophy.
As we go along, there'll be more stuff to do, and also this.
I recognize those blocks from the basement. I hope they're more structurally sound after the super merge, but I doubt it.
Alright. Yeah, this was also one of the earliest Switch releases, and hey! Now we got a treasure chest. Leafy World. We found a new item. If only there was somewhere you could check it out. Yeah, it's gonna keep telling us that whenever we get items and stuff, but we won't really be able to do anything with them for a while. Now we stop. It's the devil's anus from Thor Ragnarok. Okay.
There, in the sky, see that? It began the moment the rabbits teleported into the Mushroom Kingdom. The energy we've seen floating upwards after we defeat an enemy. I wonder. All the more reason to catch that rabbit with the Super Merge headset. He's the key to stopping this, I'm sure of it.
Oh yeah, you get a red coin ring. So go through, collect all 8 red coins. It's like in Super Mario 64 fashion. Well, I guess in this case it'd be more like New Super Mario Bros, but you get it. Oh yeah, no, there's also like 3 tiers of treasure chests. There's bronze, silver, and gold. And I think gold always has weapons in it. Yes. Rumblebee, you found a new item. Well, there was somewhere you could check it out. Yeah. I guess while I'm exploring this area, I might as well go over the different characters. So I'm gonna say this now, and I guess it's not really spoilers. This game has been out for like more than 5 years at this point. So yeah, there's 8 different characters that you can play as in this game. Not really counting Beepo, because like he acts mostly like a cursor and he doesn't really fight. Yeah, there's 8 different characters in the game. Each Mario character has a rabbit counterpart. It's like, yeah, as you already saw, there was Rabbid Mario, and Luigi's in this game, and Peach is too. So the 4 main characters in this game are Mario, Luigi, Peach, and Yoshi, all of them having a rabbit counterpart, and each character works differently, and I cannot solve a basic puzzle. And I kind of forgot you could rotate the camera like this. I am big stupid. I'm big stoop. Oh, wait, this was here. Hooray for my big, large brain. But yeah, I might as well go over these 3 characters. You won't really get to see them at their fullest potential yet, because right now all we can really do is run, shoot, and jump. I guess bounce. And go through pipes. Which, yeah, you are able to go through these in battle as well. When they do eventually show up in battle. And we got Mario. Yeah, you got just a Mario figure. So yeah, in battle, each character kind of performs differently, and you can only have 3 at a time. But the thing with the main story is you are stuck with Mario at all times, so basically, you can only switch out your other 2 team members. So how each character works, Mario is pretty balanced. I guess I should also go over, like, different, like, stats that characters can have. They can have different, some characters can move more spaces than others. Some characters can do more damage than others, and some have more range than others, so yeah, Mario is pretty much what you'd expect. Pretty much balanced in everything. Has, average movement, range, damage, you name it. Yeah, you are stuck with him at all times, but he can be good in most situations. Although not the best in any field, I don't think he is still a good all-around character. Rabbit Peach, later on you'll get to see her as probably the best healer in the game, and she also gets a shield move later on, and also once you run into these, you go to the next level. Okay, I'm gonna have to pause my explanations real quick. Greetings, sweet golden perennial of the prairie. We are... Why did you do that?
After that strange creature with the headset got here, those guys have been nothing but bad news.
You were a rabbit too, though. I saw you. I assure you, these rabbits are not like their colleagues.
Oh, well, if you could stop him, I'll happily reward you. He's zapping his brethren left and right. Turns them real nasty.
I don't suppose you would come with us to help.
Sorry, folks, but it's time this flower took things underground.
And there he goes. Alright, now to flower bud. So now to continue my explanation. So yeah, eventually Rabbit Peach will have the ability to heal. And not just herself, she can heal other people, also this face. It's broken for now. Though considering how dangerous it is, I have a hard time believing the rabbits won't fix it. but yeah, eventually she'll be able to heal everyone around her. And I also believe we're going to get to see new things, yeah. Yep, you can also dash into enemies.
Dear people, if one is to prevail, one must practice. Please sharpen your movement skills so you can turn the tables on these rascally rabbits. I've just uploaded a few suggestions to help you guide your team in the next battle. Quick, sign your biggest fan.
Defeat all. Oh yeah, you can also get extra health in case you're stuck. I think that might impact your final rank for that level, but okay.
You can deal damage while on the move by performing a dash. Select the cell with an enemy and press A.
Also, you can cover more ground with a team jump. Select the cell with any ally and press A.
How about an epic combo? After you dash an enemy, perform a team jump with an ally.
So yeah, you can actually perform some pretty wicked stuff later on. Actually, kind of want to do this. And I think Rabbit Peach also does pretty decent damage too, and also has decent movement range. And, but yeah, she's a really great healer, and also has quite a bit of range to her. And as for Rabbit Luigi, I don't know if you've noticed already, but I think I did this that well. I guess I could kill you and just leave myself out in the open. But, yeah, I don't know if you've noticed, but he has not been able to deal that much damage. And I feel like right now he's kind of useless, but once we get access to status effects, he'll be. Oh, wow. I guess he can't even see Rabbit Peach, which. Yeah, it's possible for enemies to be out of range, and if they are out of range, then you can't really hit them. but, yeah, once we get into status elements, that's when... Oh, boy. Why did I do that? Oh, no! Crap! Just try shooting him anyways. Stupid of me. Why? I'm supposed to click on Rabbit Peach and then he's gonna dash into us. Yeah, for right now you can only dash into an enemy once, but later on you'll be able to dash into multiple. Yeah, later on you can do some crazy things. But yeah, but Rabbit Luigi's main use is status ailments, so yeah, that's going to be a thing that'll be introduced in a little bit. And by a little bit, I mean, like, it won't be for some time. Ooh. but yeah, even though he doesn't do that much damage with his gun, I believe he also has the hardest dash. And he typically has the highest status ailments percentage. Yay. Like, I think eventually he'll have access to weapons that'll guarantee that you get a status effect on your enemies. Oh yeah, and also each, I think each hero, I don't know if Rabbid Luigi is an exception to this, but, each hero has two status elements connected to their weapons. So, like, usually weapons kind of come in pairs, they'll do, like, the same amounts of damage. The only thing that changes is what status effect that they can inflict, and yeah. And also, once you walk in between, like, poles with flags, that'll indicate a battle's coming. So, yeah. It's time to pull together everything you've learned so far. Attack, movement, team jump, dash, and don't forget about cover. You can also switch heroes anytime using L and R. And between attacks, what is happening? Did you see that too, or was that just me? Well, in between attack and move, using ZL and ZR. Do your best. Oh, I should also mention, sorry, if I can show this off. So yeah, you can kind of see it's flashing. When it flashes bright, that's damage that's guaranteed to be dealt. And I don't think you can really see it, but typically there is kind of like a not as bright flash that'll, like, and that's like, oh yeah, see when this is next, or yeah, when this, when that symbol's next to the health bar, that means that you're guaranteed to kill him on the next turn. Or with that attack. There you go. It'll show. Yeah. So, yeah, the bright range is damage that's guaranteed to be dealt. Anything in that not as bright range is damage that can be dealt. So, like the furthest left is, like, the most... the maximum amount of damage it can do. So you kind of have to, sometimes you might have to play around luck in high damage rolls, kind of like with Pokemon. But yeah, other times you can be able, or you are able to play it safe and just going for the kill. My mind is out of this world right now, and I do not know why. But yeah, as you saw, there are coins spawn. You can use Beepo to pick it up. Other enemies can also pick up coins, I believe, and I... oh, never mind, I didn't screw myself. This is gonna go right through. Yeah, I think enemies can pick up coins as well, which can be annoying sometimes, but... yeah, if you're able to, you're gonna want to pick up coins. Oh yeah, and I don't know if you've put this together, but your battle rank depends on how fast you can win and how many allies are alive at the end of the battle. So I don't think we're going to have to worry about dying for a little longer, but eventually that is going to be something that we'll probably worry about.
Mario, the creature with the headset got away, but I suppose you did clean up his mess. Being a plan of my word, looks like I owe you a reward.
Our good friends Rabbid Luigi and Rabbid Peach helped as well.
Yeah, great. One coin. There.
That just froze Rabbid Luigi.
Okay, here.
Yeah, this game is pretty funny. Yeah, he gave us a figure of himself. That's not narcissistic in the slightest. I think I'm gonna stop recording for today. My throat hurts now, and I don't know if I'm gonna be able to go on. So, there's this. You haven't learned how to do this yet. So yeah, there's areas that we're gonna see that we are not able to access just yet, but we should be able to come back at a later point and do that, if I can remember. But anyways, next time on... I almost said Luigi's Mansion 3. It's still a force of habit. Actually, I guess I'll explore a little more. Okay, never mind. This is an area that we can't do anything with. Next time on Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle, we'll... I'm gonna keep going until we hit the... Nope, not you. Okay. You can wait. Next time on Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle... Wait, never mind. We should be able to... Or have Beepo talk about that over there. So normally when you see stuff like that, Beepo can talk about it. There. Hey you! It's a stripe on a garden hose, not a border. Don't let your love be divided! Alright. But, yeah, next time on Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle, we'll continue through World 1 and see what Toad has to say. So, I'll see you guys in the next one. And that's kind of funny to see. And goodbye!